Hey guys, today we're gonna be doing a tutorial on a barely alive style growl. It was in the tutorial I just posted about making a drop, this exact drop. So basically the drop, or not the drop, the sound we're going to be making is this one. Most of the time it's what the actual synth we're going to be making today. That was a bit of a modified version, but the actual one we're going to be making is somewhere in here. This is another drop that I've used it slightly in. So basically, yeah, this is another remix. It's for a competition, and the grand prize, I guess, is $100, and let's just say that I really need that. Probably end up putting it towards some new sound equipment, some new studio monitors, because I'm in desperate need. These ones are definitely not as dynamically capable as they should be, I guess you could say. No, it's not what I should say. It's the wrong, there's wrong terms, but you get what I'm saying. They're just not on par. They're only $100 pair of Oasis monitors. I mean, they're great, obviously. My mixes aren't that bad. I'm sure it'll take some time to get used to some new ones. But anyways, so basically the sound we're making is this one. No, not that one. Yeah, this one. Fairly live growl one. Take the ozone off, so let's see. So basically the main key here is just squelchy and all that good stuff. Squelchy, gritty, but still really talky and all that good stuff. So basically what we're gonna do is we're just gonna open up Massive. And if you've ever watched their tutorial, Barely Alive's tutorial on the hollow point growl, it's practically the same, but I'm going to show you guys how to do it anyways. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to pick our first and only oscillator is going to be a grown 3, and we're going to put that on bend minus plus. We're going to turn the wavetable position all the way right at 7 o'clock or 6:30, I don't know. Right in there. And basically then we're gonna take our LFO5 and we're gonna assign it there, and that is all we need for that. But I have other oscillators, and the one I used was a grown 4, and I put the wavetable position in the exact same spot, put the LFO there as well. And for these LFOs we're just gonna drag it like that, so the green touches the bottom. That. It's there, and then we're going to change our LFO to a stepper. No, performer. We want. So basically, the gray should disappear, and you will get this. That is perfectly fine, and basically, what we're going to do now is we're going to take our intensity, turn it to the left, take the performer, put it there as well. Take our intensity, put the exact same spot as the first one. And assign the performer, drag this one down a tad, drag this one down a tad as well. Now, I didn't assign this to anything in the original, so I'm not going to assign it in this one either. So basically, all we have is the grown 3, and basically, what we want to do is we want to add some bright noise to give it that airy, squelchy, you know, a little bit of stuff in there. We're gonna turn the color up to almost just past 3. We don't want any feedback, Actually, we do. We want a tad of feedback just around there. And then we're going to take our modulation off, and we're going to go to position. We're going to put that on 3, but that's not going to do anything. Just doing exactly what Fairly Alive tutorial had. So there is our ring mod. And we're going to put the ring modulation up just past the M. And phase mod, we're going to put just a tad up. And then position, just to follow it, just to be sure. We're just going to leave it exactly the same. But basically, we don't need that. At least not the position. But so filter 1, we are going to use a band reject, and we are going to put it right just above 9 o'clock, maybe 10 o'clock there. We're going to assign our performer, and we're going to drag that up so that it's basically facing the U and the T, just like dead center between the two, basically. We're going to take our bandwidth, face the A and the N. We're going to put the resonance just a tad past 50%. And then for the second filter, we're going to use a band pass. We're going to take the cutoff, drag it straight up to like 10, 11 o'clock there. Add our performer and pull it up so that it's facing the O. We're going to take our bandwidth and just put it just before 50%. Then the resonance is going to go just after 50%, just like our band reject. Now we're going to drag both these filters to the top so they're at max volume. We're going to take our mix 1 and mix 2 and pull that to the bottom. Also going to take our performer and we're going to drag that all the way up, and we're going to assign this serial and partition or whatever straight parallel. Partition, that's a computer term. Whatever, we're going to put that in the center there, as close as you can get. And then we're going to go down to our inserts and we're going to add a sine shaper. It's pretty nasty distortion, so we're going to keep the dry wet at just below half, and then the drive just a tad past 3 o'clock. And then our insert 2 is going to be a parabolic shaper. We're going to pull the dry wet just past that little slashy, or just past 50%, and the drive is going to be just before 50%, just like that. And then for our voicing, we're going to have 4 voices. Unisono, we're going to keep pitch cutoff off. Hand position, we're going to have that straight mono, and then monophonic, and then legato, so that we can have a downwards growl. As you can see, it sounds nothing like it so far, but you wait. So basically what we're going to do now is we're going to add the classic tube, and we're going to take the dry wet just past 50% again, and then pull the drive down to about 11 o'clock. And then our second one is going to be a dimension expander. We're not going to do much on this. We're going to take the dry wet, put it up to half, and the size just barely above anything at all. We're talking a tidbit. And then basically we're going to take the EQ. We're going to put the boost down like this, so it's basically subtracting certain frequencies, certain volume amounts of certain frequencies. Then we're going to drag our performer all the way down like so. I'm pretty sure this is a very touchy synth. But yeah, so basically we're going to take our oscillator and put our time up to there. This doesn't affect the actual sound, but it does help with the later stuff, and keep our insert 1 up here in the routing. I don't think we actually end up using insert 2, but it's what I had, and we're gonna keep it that way. So basically, as you can see, we have that so far. So basically, what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn our, instead of rate, we're gonna have sync and then ratio, and we're gonna do 16, and we are going to. As you can see, we are going to see here. We're going to take Click on load curve, and we're gonna pick this one, put it there, and then we're gonna have this one. Yes, drag that up. And then also we're gonna have this point triangle just like that. Just added some extra stuff in here for so it'd be interesting, I guess. I'll put that about there. Just make it kind of random however you want it, but as the main sound is going to be these first two. Then basically what we want to do is we could theoretically lower down the octave, but it doesn't work like that. I think it affects the sound on a C5 level, and the way that it works, it's not going to work. So basically we're just going to go down a few octaves and click on a G2, a sharp 2 or something, just basically down here in the 2s. And whatnot is going to be your best range. As you can see, that's not exactly the same sound. This is a very touchy synth, like I said. I'm sure if we take this down, it'll be a little bit better. But yeah, so that's basically the main sound. And if you guys like that, you can like, subscribe, click that big old subscribe button below. You know, share it with your friends. I hope you guys like the tutorial. You guys all have a great day, and I'll see you later.